So good afternoon, dear students. After discussing the concepts of RC and RL circuits and also looking into some of the problems related to RC and RL circuits, today we are going to look into some more problems related to your RC and RL circuits. So let us move to next problem. So this is your RC circuit for which we have been given that VT is equal to 12 volt for t less than 0 and VT is equal to 6 cos t for t greater than 0. Okay. So it means that before t less than 0, or means the initial conditions will be determined by this, that we have applied 12 volt across this circuit. Okay. And when we are observing this circuit at t equal to 0, or you can say that for t greater than 0, we are applying a voltage Vt equal to 6 cos t. So you can see say that for the initial condition, the voltage was 12 volt. And after that, your voltage has been changed to 6 cos t. This is one point that you need to understand. If you remember in the previous questions where we had applied unit step function or unit step voltage, that means for t less than 0, the voltage was 0. And for t greater than 0, unit voltage was there. And here it is different in a way that for t less than 0, we have 12 volt in the circuit being applied. And for t greater than 0, we have voltage applied as 6 cos t. So what does it mean that for t less than 0, our circuit has achieved a steady state corresponding to 12 volt. And when we are now observing the circuit at t equal to 0, our voltage has suddenly changed from 12 volt to 6 cos t. So this is the interpretation of the circuit that we are, you can say that, observing on the screen. Okay. So after that, we have to basically determine VC 0 plus, IC 0 plus, and derivative of VC 0 plus with respect to time. So dear students, first we will target the calculation of VC 0 plus. Let us see how to calculate VC 0 plus. Okay. So we know that the voltage across the capacitor cannot change instantaneously. So VC 0 plus, it will be equal to VC 0 minus. So it means we will have to obtain VC 0 minus first. Okay. So VC 0 minus means the voltage across the capacitor for t less than 0. So for t less than 0, we had applied 12 volt here. And this 12 volt was present in the circuit for infinite duration of time. It means this capacitor had got in the steady state corresponding to 12 volt being applied in this circuit. We know that once a voltage source has been applied for infinite duration of time, your capacitor will behave like an open circuit because it is fully charged. So it means the voltage across the capacitor at 0 minus has to be obtained. So this voltage, we can see in the circuit that this capacitor is in parallel with this 12 ohm resistance. Okay. So the voltage across this 12 ohm resistance will be the same as the voltage across this 1/4 farad capacitor. So we know that since 12 volt has been applied for infinite duration of time, this capacitor will be open circuit. So it means the current will be flowing through this loop only, because this loop is an open circuit. So we have to basically find out directly the voltage across 12 ohm resistance. And we know the voltage divider rule. So the voltage across 12 ohm resistance will be 12 divided by 12 plus 6, that is 18, multiply by, this is the applied voltage, that is 12 volt. And this value comes out to be 8 volt. So dear students, this 8 volt is the voltage across this 12 ohm resistance for t less than 0. Okay, and since these two are in parallel, so obviously the voltage across capacitor at 0 minus is also this 8 volt. So we can say that this VC 0 minus is 8 volt. So which gives us the result that VC 0 plus will also be 8 volt. This is your answer number one. Because in case of capacitor, voltage cannot be changed instantaneously. That's why VC 0 plus is equal to VC 0 minus, which is equal to 8 volt. Now let us move to second part, that is IC 0 plus. So this IC 0 plus, it needs certain calculations. Okay, we need to look into how much current will be flowing through this circuit. Okay, so if you remember, I had told you an equation for RC circuit. That equation was this one, that we have to obtain IC, that is current across the capacitor. Okay, and we have to find out IC 0 plus. IC 0 plus cannot be equal to IC 0 minus. You have to understand this, because in case of capacitor, VC 0 plus is equal to VC 0 minus. So we cannot apply that condition for current. Okay, so we'll have to obtain the equation first for VCT. And we know this equation for VCT when some voltage, external voltage is applied across this. So we had calculated this or we had seen this equation that this VCT was equal to your natural response plus the steady state response or the force response. Okay. And then solving for your, we can say, initial conditions, we had obtained the expression for this voltage across capacitor. And that thing came out to be your natural response was A e raised to power minus T by tau, where tau is your RC. And your force response was some, you can say, final voltage, that is applied voltage, this one. And if you would solve it for, you can say, initial condition. So there is some initial voltage present, the value of A will be V naught there. And in that case, we come across this situation that VCT will be V minus V naught e raised to power minus t upon tau. This is the value of, you can say, or the expression for the VCT. Okay, VC is equal to V minus V naught e raised to power minus t by tau. Okay, now what is our objective? We have to find out IC. And we know the relationship between IC and VC. The relationship between IC and VC is IC is equal to, what is that? IC is equal to C dV by dt. C dV by dt. We have to apply this equation. We need to differentiate this with respect to time. Okay. And then multiply with C. And then we will come across the expression for IC. So let me write that expression. So that will come out to be ICT is equal to V minus V naught divided by R. Okay. And multiplied with e raised to power minus T upon tau. This is the expression for current across the capacitor. If we apply ICT is equal to C dV by dt. Okay, Now we need to find out IC 0 plus, means we have to substitute T equals to 0. So if we substitute T equal to 0, then this will be e raised to power 0. That will give us e raised to power 0 equal to 1. Okay. Now we are left with IC 0 is equal to V minus V naught divided by R. Okay. Now we need to see what is the value of V, what is the value of V naught, and what is the value of V R. Okay. So we have to find out the value of V. Okay. Means the value of voltage applied across this capacitor, because V is the applied voltage. So for T greater than 0, how much voltage we are applying? 6 cos T. But this 6 cos T is here. And we need to find out V here. So it means we will have to find out the value of V here corresponding to this 6 cos T here. Okay. And for that, if you see here, you assume this capacitor as circuit element, the way we have resistance, or in a way you can say that the voltage across this capacitor will be same as the voltage across this resistance. Okay. So we will again apply voltage divider rule for this 6 cos T voltage. So that will be voltage across this 12 ohm will be 12 divided by 12 plus 6, that is 18. I think, are we making some mistake here? Just a minute, let me check. That will be 12 by 18 multiply with 6 cos T. Yeah, it is correct. 6 cos T. So if we do that, it will come out to be 4 cos T. So that sir, means...
Excuse me, sir.
Just a minute. So, okay, students, we have basically calculated the voltage across this 12 ohm resistance at T equal to 0 plus, which comes out to be 4 cos T. Means the value of V is 4 cos T, which is the applied voltage across this resistance. And V naught is the initial voltage of this capacitor. And in the previous portion, we had calculated that initial value as 8 volt. That is VC 0 plus. That was equal to VC 0 minus. That was 8 volt. Okay. So here you can see here that IC 0 plus is equal to V minus V naught by R. And what is V? V is 4 cos T. Okay. Minus V naught, that is 8, divided by R. What is R? This R is not this 12 ohm resistance. This R is the equivalent resistance of the circuit, because ye jo R aaya hai, ye tau se aaya hai. So if you see this R, for R equivalent, if you remember, I told you that you have to short the voltage source. If you do that, this 12 ohm and 6 ohm, this will become in parallel. Okay. So the parallel combination of 12 and 6 ohm will come out to be 4. And see here, we have to obtain IC 0, means T will be 0 and cos 0 will be 1. So this will be 4 minus 8 divided by 4, which comes out to be minus 1 ampere. This is the value of IC 0 plus. Though it seemed to be a very simple question, very simple calculation, but in this very single question, so many concepts have been cleared. Okay. So after calculating VC 0 plus, then IC 0 plus, now we move to calculation of dVC 0 plus by dt. And this is very, very simple. We know that IC is equal to C dV by dt. So this dVC by dt, this will be equal to IC 0 plus divided by C. This is the same equation, that is your IC is equal to C dV by dt. So for dV by dt, it has to be IC 0 plus by C. And IC 0 plus is how much? Minus 1 ampere. Okay. And what is C? C is 1 by 4. So if you substitute, this value will come out to be minus 4 volt per second. This is how we will solve this numerical. So we have got to be VC 0 plus as 8 volt. We have calculated IC 0 plus as minus 1 ampere. We have calculated DVC 0 by DT as minus 4 volt per second. Okay. So dear students, after discussing this problem 3.1, we move to next problem, that is 3.2. So in this question, the switch is closed at t equal to 0. So means the switch is open before t equal to 0. And we have to calculate the value of current across the capacitor, that is ICT, for t greater than 0. So you can see here that the voltage has been applied across the capacitor after t greater than 0 or at t equal to 0. Means there are no initial conditions across the capacitor. Okay, so that way we can say that the initial voltage across the capacitor is 0. Now let us try to find out the expression for this ICT. So since we have to find the expression for ICT, we know that across the capacitor, the voltage does not change instantaneously. And we have seen the expression for VCT across the capacitor. And we have also seen the same expression across the capacitor in the previous question also. So first we will find out VCT and then we will find out ICT. Okay. And the procedure that we will follow for obtaining VCT is the same procedure that we discussed in our theory class. So your VCT will be equal to its natural response plus the force response. And while calculating these two things, we will require many concepts of your circuit analysis that will help us in arriving at the answer of this question. So let us do that. We know that the natural response will be of the form exponential, that is your Vn will be is equal to A e raised to power minus t upon tau. And our tau is equal to RC. Okay. And this R is R equivalent. Okay. So we know the value of C, that is 1 by 100 farad. We need to find out the value of R equivalent. And the procedure is already known to you. What we will do, we will find out the equivalent resistance across this capacitor by shorting your voltage source and by opening up our current source. So since there is a current source here, we will open it up. Then we will see the equivalent resistance across this. And let us do that. So if we do that, these two resistances 20 and 30, they are in series. That is your 50 ohm resistance. These two are in series. And then the combination of these two is in parallel with 50 ohm. So the parallel combination of 50 and 50 will give us 25. So your R equivalent will be 25. And your capacitor is nothing but 1 by 100. And that means your tau comes out to be 1 by 4. As a result, your natural response is equal to A e raised to power minus 4t. This is the expression for natural response. Now we will find out force response. And I told you earlier also that force response will be obtained during steady state. Means we will assume that switch has been closed for infinite duration of time. And we know that under such condition, capacitor will behave like open circuit. So capacitor will be open circuit. That means the voltage across this resistance will be the voltage across this capacitor. So once the switch has been closed, we will have to find out the voltage across this 50 ohm resistance. So let us obtain that. So we assume that the switch has been closed. We will assume that the capacitor is not present in the circuit because it being the open circuit. So you can see here that the current will come out of this current source, and these two resistances, 50 ohm and 30 ohm, they are in series with each other, but these two resistances are in parallel with this 20 ohm resistance. So your current is getting divided between these two, that is 80 ohm resistance and 20 ohm resistance. Now we will apply the current divider formula. So if we do that, the current divider formula will be, first, if we want to find out the current across 50 ohm resistance, and since 50 and 30 are in series, so that's why the current across 50 and 30 will be same. So the current divider formula gives us 20 divided by 20 plus 50 plus 30, that is your 100. So it will be 20 by 100 multiply with 20 ampere current. So this will come out to be 4 ampere. So it means the voltage across this 50 ohm resistance, sorry, not voltage, the current across this 50 ohm resistance through this 50 ohm resistance will be 4 ampere. And how much will be the voltage? We know that through Ohm's law, V equal to IR. So 50 into 4, that is, and current is going in the downward direction. So the current across is 4 ampere, and the voltage across this will be 200 volt. Okay. So we can say that the forced voltage during steady state across this 50 ohm resistance, which will be same as the voltage across this capacitor, that will be 200 volt. Okay, so we have obtained the natural response. We have obtained the forced response. If we add them together, we will get the complete response. So that complete response will be equal to your VC. I'm writing VC simply just to save time. It will be A e raised to power minus 4t plus 200. Okay. And now we will apply the initial condition. We know initial condition, that is at t equal to zero, voltage is zero because there was no source applied. This will come out to be one. A will come out to be how much? Minus 200. So your VCT, it will come out to be 200 within bracket 1 minus e raised to power minus 4t. This will be the value of VCT. Now we need to calculate ICT. So in order to obtain this ICT, what we will have to do? We'll have to apply an equation, that is ICT is equal to C dV by dt. So if you do that, you can see here that you'll have to multiply with C. C is nothing but 1 by 100. 200 by 100 is 2. This one is a constant which will go away. Okay. And if you differentiate e raised to the power minus 4t, it will give you minus 4 e raised to the power minus 4t. And the final answer will be equal to the C dV by dt will give us final answer as 8 e raised to power minus 4t. This is the answer for this. Okay, which is different from what I had provided you in the assignment, but the exact answer from my side is 8 e raised to power minus 4t. So, okay, dear students, now we move to our next question. So, this is our next question, which is numbered as 3.5. So here, if you look carefully in this question, we have RL circuit. So we have an inductor and rest of the resistances are there. We have applied a voltage of 10 volt. Okay. And we are closing the switch at t equal to zero. Okay. So look at the circuit carefully, that this switch is not connected directly with the voltage source. This switch is present somewhere else. So even before your switch was closed, your voltage was already applied to this inductor. It means before this switch was closed, the inductor was already in the steady state. And we know that the steady state of the inductor is a short circuit. So you can say that what is the initial condition? For the initial condition, this inductor is a short circuit. I hope things are clear. So in any circuit, first you have to see what is the effect of closing or opening any switch in the circuit. And then you have to analyze the state of the inductor or capacitor in the initial state. So we have found that the inductor is short circuit initially. Okay. And we have to obtain an expression for IT. That is your current across the inductor. And we have already obtained the expression for current across the inductor. And the same method that we use for your capacitor, the same method will be applied for inductor for current. So your current IT will be equal to your natural response plus the forced response. So same logic we will apply here and we will come at the solution. So first let us find out natural current. Your natural current will be of the type exponential, which will be IN is equal to A e raised to power minus T upon tau. Okay, and since this is your RL circuit, your tau is nothing but L by R, and your R is nothing but R equivalent. Okay, so first we need to find out R equivalent. So let us see this thing, dear students. So once your switch has been closed, this 12 ohm resistance will also come into picture. Okay. So your R will come out to be, we have to short this voltage source. That means this 12 ohm resistance and 6 ohm resistance, those will be in parallel. Okay. And the parallel combination of 12 and 6 will come out to be 4 ohm. And we have to find out R equivalent across this inductor. Okay. So this 4 ohm that we have obtained by this combination, it will be in series with 6 ohm, and the R equivalent will come out to be 10. This will be 10. Okay. And the value of this L is 1 by 2. So this tau will come out to be 20. 1 by 20. 1 by 20. So tau is 1 by 20. So that means your natural response comes out to be A e raised to power minus 20 t. This is our natural response. Okay. So now we need to find out the force response. So force response will apply when your switch has been closed for infinite duration of time. So let us see that. So if your switch has been closed for infinite duration of time, we have to find out the current across this inductor. Okay. So we already know that for steady state, the inductor behaves like a short circuit. So let us close this switch. Now we need to find out current across this. So this is short. It means this 12 ohm and 6 ohm, they are in parallel now. Okay. So we have to first find out the voltage across this 6 ohm resistance. If we are able to find out voltage across this 6 ohm resistance, we'll be able to find out the current also. So how much voltage will be there? First 12 and 6, they are in parallel. Okay, the equivalent resistance of 12 and 6 will be your 4. Okay, now the voltage across this 4 ohm will be, we'll apply voltage divider rule, that is your 4 by 6 plus 4, that is 10, and multiply with the voltage applied, that is 10 volt. So the voltage across this 6 ohm resistance, it comes out to be 4 volt. Okay, but we need to find out the current across this 6 ohm resistance, because same current will be flowing through this inductor also, which is a short circuit. So the current through, that is your forced current, or the current through inductor in the steady state, that will be, voltage is 4 and your resistance is 6. So this value comes out to be 2/3. So this is our IF, this is our IN, and we have to find out the total current. So we will sum these two. Okay, so our IT, it comes out to be 2/3. Okay, plus A e raised to power minus 20T. This is our IT. Okay, now what is our next step? Our next step is to find out the value of A. And this A will be obtained once we know the initial value of this IT, that is initial value of current through this inductor. We have not obtained this initial value yet. So what was the initial value? Initial value, we know that the current across the inductor cannot change instantaneously. That means your I 0 minus will be equal to your I 0 plus. Okay, so we'll have to find out I 0 minus, means just before the switch was closed. So before the switch was closed, this 12 ohm resistance was not in the picture. So means the current was flowing from this 10 volt through this inductor involving only two resistances, that is 6 ohm and this 6 ohm. So these are in series. So this I0 minus or I0 plus current will be V/R, and V is how much? 10, and total resistance is 12 ohm, and this comes out to be 5/6 ampere. This is your initial current, 5/6. So now what we need to do, we will take this equation. In this equation, we will take, we will put t equal to 0. So for t equal to 0, we will substitute I0 as 5/6. This e raised to minus 20 t will be 1, and we will solve for A. And the value of A will come out to be 1/6. So your A will come out to be 1/6. This is A. So if you put this value of A here, you will get the answer, that is your IT is equal to 2/3 plus 1/6 e raised to power minus 20 t. This is the answer of your current through inductor for t greater than 0. Okay. So dear students, we stop here for the time being. We have seen the numericals related to RL, RC circuits. And I will again ask you people to solve the remaining numericals so that you can apply the concepts which are developed during the solution of today's numerical. And we will continue in the next class. Thank you. Thank you very much.